Okay, so I've got a decent amount of familiarity with Stage 1, both from having seen the author's blog and development screenshots and having played the demo and whatnot, but I'm gonna have to improvise a lot from here on out, so we'll see. The game will let me know if I'm doing too poorly. But otherwise, we'll just have to see. So, game design is always a little bit tricky because in that first stage, that first level, wherever your player just gets dropped in when you get started, you kind of have to grab them. You've got to put in those hooks. You've got to, you've got to actually show off how your game plays, why it's interesting, why it kind of separates itself out from other kinds of games, why it's worth playing. By stage two or by the later game, you kind of don't have to worry about that as much. There's, I guess, this sort of sense that by this point, your prospective player is has got some sort of investment, some sort of commitment, and they're just trying to see how things actually develop and if they want to keep playing the game versus, like, do they actually want to play the game in the first place, if that makes any sense. So, like, there's like a certain level, there's a certain tendency to want to put your flashiest stuff that you can still reasonably expect your player to deal with in that first stage so that, you know, you're showing off the capabilities of your tech, your engine, and whatnot. This is a completely, like, custom engine game, by the way, as far as I can tell. Like, the developer just worked hard on making all this scrolling and these bullet patterns just work for them, and whatever they got set up works for them. Anyway, so how does this actually work in a bullet hell game, though? Yeah, okay. Felt a little bit cramped there. Didn't want to deal with it. Like, this is just the I don't want to deal with it button. It's not quite that perfect. That's not the right button. Oh, I know. It's because, I need to switch over to that. We want to start off using this. There we go. Very, very different, pattern there. But we can pause and switch to that later on, the Lance, if we want to. Yeah, I think the save game just might not save the arms, the secondary weapon that I have saved, that I used from last time since I closed and restarted the game. But that's fine. Like, that's something I can deal with. I know exactly how tricky designing a save system can be, so, you know, this is very much, how do I phrase this? Like, it's not in the style of the olden days, although it certainly would have been. Not to really, like, excuse that in any sort of way, but it's nice to have consistency when you start up the game, I guess. One certainly has to, like, lower the amount of complexity when reloading a game. Yeah, there we go. That's what I'm getting at. Anyway, I appreciate this is the kind of game that just kind of lets you run and gun. Like, it doesn't really put anything into your way. All the dialogue is set aside in these rooms if we want, so. Oh. So, like, there's nothing really stopping you from just going ahead and just running straight to your destination. Like, if you just want to do all the combat possible, if you want to just, There's probably a way in there, but I don't know what it is. But anyway, yeah, there's no, like, you never have to stop, I guess. You can go at full speed if you want to. Okay, this is a nice subtle glow effect. I appreciate this. Like, as far as flickering goes, this is pretty tolerable. Like, I've certainly seen a lot worse and been okay with that, but I'm glad that attention was paid to this kind of thing. Of course, this does make me wonder if the lights are gonna go out at some point. But I always appreciate a little palette change every now and then. Just to keep things interesting. And just to, kind of divide up the physical space a little bit more, too. Yeah, there we go. Well, so far so good. I mean, these, Stage 2 is usually where things start showing at least a little bit of teeth, but not too many. I think usually in, like, a 6-stage game, Stage 3 and Stage 4 are the real killers as far as, filtering you out and making you start losing lives or losing resources or really, like, starting making you wonder how you actually deal with this sort of stuff. Whereas, so far at least, I've certainly been taken off guard by stuff, but it's usually been fairly straightforward how to actually deal with things. Like, the puzzle in a pattern is not always, like, how to dodge something. Like, sometimes it's just reacting to something and, like, reading it, I guess you could say. There's a lot of distinct skills involved with, dealing with bullet patterns and, oh, okay. Okay, standing still was not the correct thing to do. I should have bombed. That's right. C is not my thrust key. C is my bomb key. My, become invulnerable key. Okay, there we go. That's better. See, it's a good thing I'm not strafing now. I can just flick back and forth. This is exactly what I was talking about. I'll take that. Oh, that didn't heal... Okay, so it didn't heal me up all the way. I guess I have to stand in it to regenerate all the way. That's interesting. So you can't just run through them, like I was talking about earlier. You do have to actually stop a little tiny bit. Yep. There we go. I guess that's mildly interesting that they can actually spot these sorts of things ahead of time and... like, see it before it sees them. Which is usually what you want. That's how combat works. If you can see your enemy before they see you, usually that gives you an advantage. You decide the terms of engagement. You figure out exactly how you want to, approach things. Or sometimes you can even take them by surprise. The preemptive strike does not always work, but when it does, it's glorious. But this isn't a military doctrine kind of, game. This is a run-and-gun game. This is not the Fire Emblem-like strategy game. I'm just running through here with my max-level unit that has all the stat boosters on it. That's just how this game goes. Well, so far, so good. I've gotta say, like, I'm actually subtly impressed with every single thing I've been seeing so far here. Like, there isn't a single screen here that kind of feels, like, filler-ish. And even, sections with a little bit of repetition in them usually end before that repetition actually starts to weigh in on you. Like, it's just long enough to get the point across. And to, like, form an actual discrete section where your movement speed matters, and your DPS matters, and the choice of whether to kill as you go or try and run past matters. Okay, so the message I'm getting here right now is I'm actually being too conservative with this laser. Like, I should be using it more. Because I should actually be running out of it. Like, that's the perk I picked, is being able to recharge the energy, so I should be using this with much more wild abandon. Like, it's not going to be perfect in all circumstances, of course, but... about that. Sorry. Yeah, this is a momentum kind of game. Like, it wants you to go forward, but there's nothing that, like, inherently pushes you forward. Like, you don't get vacuumed forward by any kind of script triggers or cutscenes or anything like that. Just wants you to go forward and do the stuff, and it doesn't really get in your way. A wide arena. Is its hitbox down there? Yeah, it does look like it might be. Okay, yeah, I'm still hitting it even if I'm hitting it down there. Okay, cool. Alright, well, might as well, use all that. Alright. Now I gotta pause. Yeah, okay, so that's the way to do it. Okay. Okay. That's not a lot of laser. That's gonna take a lot of lancing to recharge that. Oh, but I do get a recharge right here. Okay, cool. Not sure how good the laser is going to be in a case like this, but we'll see. So I've thought at some time or another that I might want to make a game like this as far as either a vertically scrolling shmup or maybe something a little bit more ambitious than that. I think the... Interesting. Oh, right, that was the mid-boss, not the actual boss. Don't be ridiculous. That just goes to show just how much work you need to do as far as balancing enemy HP and trying to figure out what the characteristics are of your enemies. Like, is it okay to have the player destroy them as soon as they show up on screen to preempt their attack? Or do you want to give them enough HP that they will almost certainly get their attack off, regardless of whether you kill them or not? Or, do you want to make it that kind of a DPS race where it's hard to preempt it before it goes off? Okay. There we go. There we go. I mean, I guess those are kind of, like, the three main HP levels that are meaningful. There we go. Minimal movements. Micro-dodging. I've read the book. I wonder if these are kind of the independent parts that I can destroy. Maybe it is. Might be a little bit tricky to... Yeah, there we go. Do that. I don't think I actually managed to hit with any of those. I read the manual. I know what's up. Shotgun's not gonna help me out much here. Okay, good. The hitbox is exactly where I would think it would be, in the center. I like the use of slow bullets here to make it not just possible to just go back and forth. Like, you have to actually use more of the screen. That's cool. Well, we need those. How are we going to find them otherwise? There. Command, I guess. Okay. We're just gonna have a little bit of intrigue behind the scenes. Not too much, not enough to get in the way, but enough to kind of let you stew on that while everything else is going on. I've got 8 of these, I better spend them. What's expensive? This is really expensive. How good is that? Ah! Danger Mario setup. I understand. Oh. I guess these are both 6, so you could probably only have 1 of these. Yeah. But, interesting. So, yeah, they're the exact same. So it's just a matter of, do you want to be flawless, or do you want that last chance, sort of thing. Where do you imagine you're going to spend the most time? And there's synergies involved, of course, naturally. Like, this is good if you have HP regeneration, so you can get injured a little bit and then heal yourself back up before you get hit a second time. Or this probably goes well with the, last chance, so now you could be invulnerable for 6 seconds and do more damage. That said, 6 seconds is not that much time. Like, it's enough to finish off the boss if you're, like, that close to finishing it off. But it's not that much. So, usually in these kinds of games, any kind of action game, I usually don't tend to bother with this too much. We already got that one. Okay. Nothing wrong with just having more HP, though. Yeah. Do I just want 25% more again? Is that additive or multiplicative? What would I be getting instead of that? Just more laser. More laser wouldn't hurt. Okay, yeah, more laser. I know what I want. There we go. Gotta get those bars nice and long. There we go.